Yeah, see, right, we have different operators, right? Arithmetic operators, assignment operators, relational, increment and decrement operators, logical operators, bitwise, conditional, and special operators. Okay. Yeah. We discussed those questions, guys. From these operators, what kind of questions, right? One by one we discuss based upon okay, what kind of question they may ask. Yeah, I will show you some questions, right? Yeah, guys. Relational and arithmetic operators. See this question, guys. Tell me the answer. See this question and tell me the answer. Yeah, very good. Here, relational operator. This question on relational operators and arithmetic operators are involved, right? Yeah, what is the relational operators? Either it returns, relational operators returns.
हेलो सर,
Either 0 or 1. Okay, relational operators returns either 0 or 1. Yeah, see this, guys. First, which one will be evaluated? Right? First parenthesis is there, right? First parenthesis is there. We have declared A, B, C values. A is 10, B is 5, and C is 5. D value. B plus C. What B plus C here? First, this one will be implemented, right? Executed 5 plus 5 is 10. 10 equals to, it compares with A. A value is almost 10 equals to 10. Is it correct? Yes. Then it returns what? D value is 1. Then answer is B. Okay? Because relational operator. For example, if I remove this parenthesis, guys, tell me I remove this parenthesis, then what will be the output? If I remove the parenthesis, what will be the output? Yeah, what is the answer? Yeah, very good. Some are saying 6 and 5, 6 and 5, right? 5. Many are saying 5. Meghana, you said error. Why it's error? Yeah, guys. We remove also, nothing will happen, guys. Arithmetic operators are having higher precedence than relational. Okay, first B plus C will be performed. B plus C, what is B plus C? Then 5 plus 5, 10. Arithmetic operators are having higher precedence. No need of parenthesis. Okay, then now answer also same one. You understood, right, guys? There is no confusion. Don't get confusion, right? Next. Yeah. What about this answer, guys? See, reminder, minus 3 by percentile 2. Minus 3 percentile 2. Yeah, while doing minus 3 percentile 2. We are dividing with 2. See, if you have negative number, your negative number should come, guys. Okay, don't take one time. Minus, if I take one time, what happens? 2 it comes. But you should not take positive number. Your negative number is there, here also negative. Positive number is occur, here also positive number should come. Minus one time. Take minus one time, this is a minus 2. Now subtract. By subtracting, signs will change. This is plus. So answer is how much? Minus 1. What is the answer? It's the minus 1. Okay, no? Reminder. You understood, guys? While subtracting. Yeah, one more question. Yeah, this one is logical operators. 14th one. Logical operators. Tell me the answer. Yeah, all are saying A. Yeah, very good, guys. You're giving response, right? Very good. Yeah, see. Logical operators you should know. Logical AND. When it works. First one, logical AND, guys. What is logical AND? When we are working with the logical AND operator, if both conditions are true, then only it is true, guys. First condition true, second condition true. Then output is what? True. Okay. First condition true, second condition true. Then output is true. If any one condition, if the first condition is false, guys, it doesn't evaluate second condition. That is a logical AND. Okay. If the first condition is, our first expression is, the first expression is false, it doesn't evaluate second expression. Okay, what is the logical OR, guys? What is logical OR? If both conditions are false, then only it is false. If any one condition is true, both conditions are false, then only it is false. Any one condition is true, then it is true. Okay. For example, if the first condition is true, no need to evaluate second condition. First, both conditions true, true. Okay. If any one condition is true, then it is true only. Okay. For example, if the first condition is true, no need to evaluate second condition. Directly, it is what? True only. Okay. Now, next one is, if the first expression is true, it doesn't evaluate second expression. Same. What is the difference? If the first condition is false, it doesn't evaluate. If the second condition is false, if the first condition is true, then it doesn't evaluate. Small difference, that's all. Okay. First one, x. What is the x, guys? X is 1, y is 0, z is 5. Int a equals to a value are calculating. Okay. Is printing z value. No problem. X equals to, what is x? 1. 1 means what? True. Then AND operator is there. Okay, true, right? That's why it checks the second condition. What is second condition here? 0. 0 means false. then it evaluates. Z plus plus, 6 is the answer. Okay. For example, if you have AND operator, that is different again. Okay. Z plus plus, what is Z value? 6 is the answer, guys. Clear? Now 15th question, same 15th question, tell me the answer first, 15th. Yeah, very good, guys. Many are saying answer is B. Yeah, we check it. First one, X is 1, true. That's why I check the second condition. If the Y is false, then it doesn't evaluate. Z is what? 5 only. Answer is B. Okay? Good. Next, we should not write return statements here. Conditional operator. Yeah, guys, this one. 70th one, bitwise operators. What are the bitwise operators, guys? Left shift. We have many left shift, right shift, bitwise XOR. These are bitwise operators. Is a left shift operator, is a right shift operator. Yeah, what is left shift, what is right shift? Okay, what is left shift, guys? It moves 2 left shift 1. For example, 2 into 2 power 1 it is, 2 into 2 power 1 it is. This is a 4. 2 left shift 2. What is 2 left shift 2? 2 into 2 square. 2 into 2 square, it is what? 8. 2 left shift 3. 2 into 2 cube. 8. Then it is 16. 2 left shift 4. 2 into 16. Then it is 32. Okay. This is left shift, guys. A shortcut operator. Directly shortcut. 2 into. Right? Yeah. If it is a right shift, what? By. For example, how do you use right shift? 16 right shift 1. What is 16 right shift 1, guys? 16 by 2 power 1. Then it is what? 8. Right shift operator. 16 right shift 2. What is 16 right shift 2? 16 by 2 square. 4. Then how much it is? 16 by 4 is 4. 16 right shift. 3, 16 by 8, goes to, what is 16 by 8, guys? Then it is 2. Clear, guys? Is the answer is what? X left shift 3. What is X? X is 1. 1 left shift 3. 1 into 2 cube. 1 into 2 cube is 8. 1 into 2 cube. Then it is 8. Next, bitwise OR operator. Next one, guys. 18th one. Tell me answer for 18th one. Next one. Bitwise operators only. Yeah, guys, expecting answer from you. Yeah, very good. Yeah, Aditi Sai, very good. Sai Kartik, Ravali, yeah, good. Pratyusha, good. Yeah, see your question, guys. X and Y, first X is 0, Y 2, Z 3. This is bitwise AND operator, right? Yeah, what is bitwise AND, bitwise OR? Same operators, guys. See, we have to convert into binary format. X and Y first. Yeah, how to do this is X and Y. This is X and Y you have to do. What is X value? 0, right? 0 value is this. Y value is how much? 2. 0, 1, 0. Then how to do it this? AND operator, if 0, 0, what is mean by 0, 0? False. False, false is false. 0, 1 is 0. Then this is false. Again, 0. R, Z value. This value, R, Z. Okay? Result. Whatever the result you got, Z. What is Z value, guys? 0, 1, 1. Then this answer is how much? 0. 0, 0 is R operator. What is R operator? When one condition is true, then it is true. Both conditions false. 0, 0 is 0. 0, 1 is what? 1. 0, 1 is 1. Then this answer is how much, guys? 0, double 1. Then answer is 3. Which option is correct? A option is correct. This is clear, guys? Next. This 19th one, guys. 19th one. What is the question? What is the final value of J in the below code? And this is also logical operators. B option is correct. Sri, check brother. Yeah, we check it. Yeah, I is 0, J is 0, guys. I and J equals to I plus 10. I and J equals to I plus 10, right? Now, see this question. See, I is 0, J equals to 0. I and what is J value here? What is AND operator, guys? If AND operator, you know, guys, what is AND operator? This condition is true, then only check this condition, right? I is 0. 0 means false. This condition it has to check. I plus 10. What is I plus 10? 0 plus 10. does it evaluate? It's a false, right? It won't evaluate. Okay, because this is false. If it is true only, then it checks. Now what is j value? It won't evaluate. Then j is become 0. J value is 0 only, guys. Okay, j value is 0. For example, if I equals to 1, if I change, if I equals to 1, then what will be the output? Can you assign the values in if condition? Yes, we can assign. Okay, nothing to do anything. We are not doing anything. Yes, the I is 1. 1 means what? True, guys. Whenever it is true, I equals to 1. It is true. When it is true, does it evaluate? Yes, it evaluates. I plus 10. 1 plus 10. 11 it is. And answer is how much, guys? 11. If it is true, then it evaluates. It's 11. Okay? Are you following, guys? How it evaluates? Next one, 23rd one. Tell me the answer for 23rd one. Yeah, what is the answer, guys? A is 10, B is 5, C is 3. B not equals not A. B value, C. What is B and what is C value, guys? What is B and what is C? Here you can check it, guys. Are you changing the B value? We are not changing the B value, right? B is almost 5 only, guys. But C equals to not not A, we have written. C equals not not A. What is not not A? Not not 10 it is. A is almost, guys, 10. Not not 10. What is not not 10? It is not 10 is first 0. Not. See, not not 10. What is not 10? It's a true, right? Then it is 0. Then this value is almost again. Not 0 is 1. Now C value is 1. Okay, what is B value? B value are not changing. B is 5 only. 5 is answer. Which option is correct? A option is correct, guys. Why D? No, it's not D correct. It's not correct answer. We are not changing the B value. Yeah. A value is correct. See, this is what b naught equals to. When b value will be changed, for example, b equals to b naught equals to naught a, if I write, then this b value will be modified. We are not changing the b value. When value will be modified, assignment operator you have to use. B equals to b naught equals to. This is a relational operator. These statements are called dummy statements, guys. Dummy statements means it won't affect any code. That's all. Okay, b naught equals to naught a. If I write b naught equals to naught a, nothing will happen here. B naught equals to naught a. Clear? Are you following us? B equals to B naught equals to naught a. This is the answer. Now b value are not modifying. B is 5 only. Okay, next. Yeah, this is arithmetic completed, right? Earlier. Yeah, next 31st one, guys. See once. This one, tell me the answer. Many are saying A and C, C, right? Yeah, first A value is 10, guys. B value is 10. If A equals to 5, then B minus minus CP happens, right? Yeah, A equals to 5. Can I ascend like this? Yes, we can ascend, guys. If A, in if condition, can we write like this? Yes, we can write. What is A value? That depends upon A value, it works. Here A is 10, is there the 10. Can I modify the A value is 5? Yes, we can modify. Now A equals to how much, guys? 5 now. If A, if 5, true, then it is true, B minus minus. What is B minus minus? Then 10 become 9. If this condition is true, B minus minus. Finally print A and B minus minus value. A is how much? A is 5, B minus minus. Already here, B minus minus means 9. It won't decrement because post decrement, right? Then answer is 5 and 9. Answer C is option is correct. Okay, this option is C. Yeah, not B. Answer is C. Who said C? Yeah, many of. Very good. Answer is C, guys. The option is correct. C. Next one. Yeah, this one, 37th one. Yeah, what is character ch equals to, see this one. Yeah, character A. Yesterday class we discussed character ASCII values, you should remember guys, small A ASCII value is 97, A equals to 97, 97 percentile 10. 7 it is, 7 plus plus. Can you write 7 plus plus? Yeah, what is 7 plus plus? If you write 7 plus plus, then it is error. C option is correct. Who said C? No one. Option C. C guys. It's error. Okay, it's not A, it's not D. Constant cannot be incremented. Remember, I plus plus is valid. I plus plus is valid. For example, A plus plus is valid. B plus plus is valid. Because the variables can be modified. A plus B, what is A plus B guys? It's not variable. Remember, A plus B, whole increment is not possible. A plus B plus plus. A plus B is a constant. A is a variable, B is a variable. But A plus B is not variable. A minus B, for example, A minus B you have written. What is A minus B result? A minus B plus plus. That is errors. Same, A percentile 10. It's a result. Result plus plus is constant. A is a variable, B is a variable, but A plus B is not variable, guys. Constant. Clear, I think you understood, right? Why it is error? A percentile 10, it's a what? Result. Result plus plus is not valid. For example, if only A is there, then it is valid, guys. Clear? I think you understood. Guys, right? Next one. Yeah. Answer for this. Yeah, which option is correct, guys? This one, 39th one. Yeah, answer in integer x equals to minus 5. Then what is the answer, guys? Yeah, we are printing percentile D. What is percentile D, guys? Minus 5. Does it print? Yes, minus 5. Answer is minus 5 only, guys. C option is correct. C option is correct. Yeah. Answer in integer, can I print percentile D? Yes. See, forget about this line. Forget about this line. What we are printing? We are printing something. Which value? X value. You are printing in decimal format, that's all. Is it decimal? It's a decimal but unsigned value. It's an unsigned value. What is the format specified for unsigned value? Percentile U. But you have to use percentile U. But we did not use percentile U. Percentile D, I am using. Minus 5. Can it print minus 5? Yes, it can print minus 5. Then our answer is what? Minus 5. Okay, for example, if I use instead of this percentile U, what is the difference? For example, percentile U and X value. For this one and this one, this value is minus 5 because it's a minus 5. Percentile D means negative numbers can print. But percentile U cannot print minus 5. Then it is not, it won't give any error, guys. Conversion. You are printing, this is what? Negative number, signed integer. They are printing in unsigned format. Unsigned int format. I think, guys, whether it is any form, we can print convert into another form. No problem. While converting, it won't give any error. Automatic type conversion it converts. For external conversion, you should use. For example, this is unsigned integer. We are converting into, see, this is unsigned, you declared. This is signed value assigned. What happens when you assign, it converts and it prints. We are going to print unsigned format. Minus 5 is unsigned? No. Then how it converts? You know, right? This range is what? Unsigned integer range is 0 to 65,535. 0 to 65,535. Zero to 65,535. If I give minus one, what happened? Minus one, guys. If I give minus one, then this value takes. If I give, for example, same clock, guys, in the clock, wall clock, you know, right? After 12, what happens? Again, one comes, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 12 hours, right? We did not prepare 24 hours watch, right? We prepared 12 hours only. Okay, up to 12 hours. After 12 hours, again, it is one. Same here. 0 to, this is circular manner, guys, till 65,535. Again, if your next value is what? Again, it is 0. 65,536. If I give 536, then it takes 0. Now normal way only, guys. If now 12, after 12, 13 hours means what? 13 hours means 1 p.m. 14 hours means what? 2 p.m. 15 hours, 3 p.m. Like that, same. 65,535 is 0. 36 is 1. 37 is 2. 38 is like this. Same minus 1. If I give minus 1, what value it gives? 65,535. Minus 2. If I give minus 2, next value. Minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Like this, it takes the values. Okay, if I give minus 5, guys, for example, minus 5, count. Can you count like this? Yes, we can count and we can tell. But sometimes, if I give minus 26, what happens? Can you count minus 26? Like this? This value, right? Minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 26. That is not possible. That's what to do. We have to subtract 65,536 minus which value, guys? Minus 5. What is this value, guys? 65,531. Then this is the answer. Okay? 65,536 minus 5. And the answer is 65,531 is the answer. Clear? Which option is correct? E option is correct. Yeah, this one answer. Guys, tell me shortcut operators. Yeah, six, sir. Which option is correct, guys? Six, sir. Okay, x into x. Yeah, we check it this question. Yeah, x is 2, y is 1, right? How it works? X is 2, y is 1. Yeah, we are going to print some x value. Yeah, what is the statement we are going to write? See this. I'm going to write this statement x in 2 equals to x plus y. Yeah, first which one will be executed, x plus y or x into, can you consider like this x equals to x into x plus y. This one correct or x equals to x into x plus y. Which one is correct? First expression or the second expression? Which one is, this one is correct or this one is correct? Second, yeah, we check it. If second or first one, answers we check it, guys. If it is the first one, what will be the answer? First, this one will be evaluated, right? X into X. How much? 2, right? 2 into 2, 4 plus 1, 5. You may get answer is 5 here. In this case, 2 into 3. Alright? 2 into 3. Then it is 6 you will get. First one or second one, we check it. What is the answer, guys? Yeah, what is the answer? 6. Right, guys? We have answer is 6. Difference you understood? Don't consider as like this. If you have this operator, don't consider as like this. This is not correct. This is correct. First x plus y will be performed. Okay? For example, if it evaluates 2 into 2, then we will get answer is 5. In this case, we will get 6. Difference you understood, I think, right? Next one, this answer is what? 6. The B option is correct. Yeah, very good. Next one, guys. Yeah, now tell me answer for this. 40, first one. Yeah, guys. Answer is 2 now. First, which one will be evaluated? X by y. What is x by y? 2 by 2 is 1. Again, x by y. Then answer is 2 by 1. His answer is A. Option A is correct. I think you understood this kind of questions how to do. First, right side value. If there's a shortcut operators are there, right side value how to evaluate. Okay, now? Next. Yeah, what about 42nd one? Tell me answer for 42nd next one. Yeah, answer is not answer wrong. It's a D. It's not D, right? Many are saying D. Kishan Prasad. Answer is Sai Sampriti. Answer is A. Compile time error. Shortcuts only for arithmetic, not for other data types. Okay? Shortcuts only for arithmetic guys. The 42nd one compilation error because x equals to a equals to a plus 1. Can I write shortcut for this a equals to a plus b? How to write shortcut? Then we can write a plus equals to b. A equals to a minus b. Shortcut how to write a minus equals to b. A equals to a and b. Then how to write shortcut a and equals to b. Okay, no? Then this is a shortcut. A equals to a and b, a and equals to b. A equals to a plus b. We can write only arithmetic operators, only shortcuts we can write. This is a logical bitwise, you can't write for logical and other operations. This is a compilation error, compile time error, right? Yeah, next one. Yeah, this one, guys, 49th one. Yeah, answer is yeah, very good. 10-14 or 10-7. We check it, guys. Now A is 3. First, which operation? First, we should know, guys. Which operation will be executed? Arithmetic or bitwise? First, arithmetic, guys. A plus 2 first. A plus 2. What is A plus 2? 3 plus 2, 5. 5 left shift 1. 5 left shift 1. 5 into 2 power 1. 5 into 2 power 1. What is 5 into 2 power 1? It's a 10. Okay, this answer is 10. A plus 2 left shift 1. Okay. What is A plus 2 left shift 1? 2 left shift 1 first here. A value is 10 here. 2 left shift 1. What is 2 left shift 1? 2 into 2 power 1. 2 into 2 power 1 is how much? 4. Here A plus 4. 10 plus 4. 14. And answer is 10 and 14. A value modified. That's why here it is 10. 10 plus 6 is 4. 14. Then answer is 14. 10, 14. A option is correct. Okay. Next 50, first one, right? Yeah, tell me answer for this. Can you write like this? Is it valid or not? We check it. Yeah, here we are printing how many values? C. Yeah, answer is C. Many are saying D. It's not a D because here how many values you are printing? Percentile, percentile. Two values only it is printing, but we are passing number of values. But how many values it is printing is important. Answer is C, guys. Okay, this answer is C. Yeah. Percentile I and j values. What is I and j value? 10, 3. That's all. Answer is 10, 3. Yeah, see, that's all in this operators. Now we discuss control statements questions, some control statements questions. Yeah, first question, guys. Yeah. Check the first question and tell me the answer. Control statements. Yeah, what is the answer, guys? Yeah, C answer is correct. Very good. Because see, first one, there is no break statement in each case. Break is mandatory. No, break is not mandatory. Second case two, expression as in case 3 plus 2 is not allowed. 3 plus 2 is allowed. Okay, anything is allowed. Expression value you can write. Variables we can't write. Yeah, duplicate case, case 5. Yes, this is error. No error will be reported. This option is not correct. Answer is C. C option is correct. Yeah, second one is, guys, next one. Yeah, this one. Yeah, see this question and tell me the answer. How many times this will be printed? See, option is correct. Zero times. Yes, guys. Answer is zero times. Because minus one. Continue means what? Break means what? You know, right? Minus one left shift. Minus one less than 10. Minus one less than 10. Yes, true. But minus one left less than 5. Continue. It won't execute this. X plus plus. Zero. Zero less than 10. Zero less than 5. Continue. 1 less than 5, 2 less than 5, 3 less than 5, 4 less, till x less than 5, continue this expression, don't print it. Whenever it is equal to 5, for example, it's a 5, 5 less than 5, false, else break, it comes outside, it is not going to print. 0 times is answer, answer C is answer, okay? Yeah, next one. Yeah, this one, 6th one, guys, check the 6th one. Yeah, I equals to 0, I less than 5, I equals to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. This will how many times will execute, guys? That many times it increment. This 5 times will increment, right? Whenever it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whenever it is 5, it won't execute. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 times it execute. Whenever it is 5, it won't increment. Okay? Then what is the A value here? 5 is the answer. D option is correct. How many said correct? D. Yeah, very good. Many of. Yeah. Abdul. Abdul, he said. Answer C. C option is wrong. Janavi. D option is correct. Yeah. Very good, guys. Yeah, next, the same question. With continue. Yeah, now tell me answer for this. Yeah, answer is, guys, 3. Yeah, we check it. D option. Some are saying D, some are saying 3. Yeah, we check it. How many times it executes? Whenever it is 0, it executes once. Okay? Whenever it is 1, it executes second. Whenever it is 2. Whenever it is 3. Okay? Even 3 also. See, if it is 0, it executes. If it is 1, it executes. If it is 2, it executes. If it is 3, it executes. Whenever it is 3, A++. Okay? Then, if it is 3, I equals to 3, break. It comes outside. Then, how many times this is executing? 4 times. And answer is D. The option is correct, guys. Okay? Option D is correct, not 3. Yeah, next one. Tell me, guys, go to this now. Go to. Yeah, what is the answer, guys? B. Yeah, many are saying B, but it's not correct. Yeah, go to, you should understand, guys. I will explain. Go to is what? Go to is used to transfer the control. Go to is used to transfer the control from one place to another place within a function, one place to another place, within a function. Okay, transfer the control from one place. Go to is used to transfer the control from one place to another place within a function. Okay, if there is no go to, also called jumping statement. If there is no jumping, what happened, guys? For example, here we are writing first line, it is right. This is the first line. Now see, first statement. This is second statement. First statement, second statement, third, fourth, fifth. We have written the statements like this. First, second, right? This is second statement, right? This is third statement. Third statement, fourth statement. The fifth statement. Yeah, normal how it executes. First statement will execute, second statement will execute, third statement, fourth and fifth statement will execute. Okay, now for example here, if I write go to, I will write some statements, guys. Go to, normal flow of execution is what? First statement will execute, second statement will execute, third, fourth, fifth statement will execute. Now for example, if I write go to fifth statement, if I say go to fifth statement. Okay, what is fifth? Here I will write a fifth is this. Fifth is this. Okay. Now, what happened? First statement will execute. Second statement will execute. Fifth statement will execute directly. It will skip the this statement. Okay. For example, if there is no go to statement. Okay. For example, we are writing condition. This condition is false. If zero. What is if zero? False. Okay. Guys, see. What is the meaning of if zero false? False means what? It won't execute this. Right? Means one, there is no jumping, right? If zero, if you write if zero, then there is no jumping. If there is no jumping, what is output? First statement, second, third, fourth, fifth. Normal only it executes. Because here we have written, when should we jump? Because if the condition is true, then jump. Okay, this condition is what? False. The false, no jumping. That's the meaning. Come to the question. Here what? If I is 0, jump, go to the label. Okay. What is the meaning of this? If it is 0, means if the condition is true, then jump. There is no jumping, right? B. because I is not zero. Normal flow means this statement will execute, 5 will execute and A will be executed. 5 and A is the answer. Answer C is the correct. D is not correct. Okay. Dharani, C answer correct. C answer is correct. Okay. Many of said B. B answer is wrong. I think you understood this concept. Go to means what? Go to, if there is no go to, normal flow. If go to is there, jumping will be there. Are you following? Jumping without, there is no jumping. Go to fifth statement means it goes to fifth statement and it executes. Clear? Yeah, next one. Yeah, this one guys, tell me ninth one. You can tell the answer easily. Ninth one. The answer is B. Some are saying B, some are saying C. Rahul. M. Rahul. What is the answer? Yeah, answer is what? Percentile 1, percentile 2, right? L1, L2, labels are there. There is no go to. If there is no go to, jumpings are not there. 1, 2, 3 is the answer. Okay. Now answer is 1, 2, 3. B option is correct. Clear? Yeah, next one. This one, guys, 10th one. So it is to understand. Okay. It is, you can understand easily. Yeah, tell me the answer, guys. Misplaced. No, it's not misplaced else. Okay, it's correct only. Yeah, see this, guys. Yeah, see this. If else, this is if, guys, this is infinite loop. If this condition is true, it goes to infinite loop and it stops this. Okay, it's not infinite loop also. See this. Percentile is writing print of if, is writing print of if a is how much? 10. A is 10. What is trying to print? This statement is printf. Percentile d, a greater than or equals to 10. We are printing this statement. What is the meaning of this statement? You know, right? See this. Printf of percentile a is great. A is almost 10. 10 greater than or equals to 10. What is 10 greater than or equals to 10? Is it true or false? It's a 1. This answer is 1. Printf value is 1. Okay, I will substitute 1 here. Substitute the 1 value here. 1. If of 1 minus 10. What is the if of 1 minus 10? If minus 10. Minus 9 it is. Right? Minus 10. What is minus 9? True it is. Whenever it is true, it goes to the loop. Loop is what? Break we have written. It comes outside. Then what is final it prints? The statement prints 1, right? Then that is the answer is 1. What is the question? What will be the output if you execute the following code? Only 1 is the answer. Then 10th one is answer is 1. Not BC. The answer is correct. Okay, now? Yeah, next one, guys. 11th one. Plus plus a. Yeah, what is plus plus a? Your R operator is there. It expression two expressions are there. First expression true or false? If plus plus a. What is plus plus a, guys? Now it is 6. If 6 is true, R operator is what? It is true, right? Whenever it is true, then the statement will be printed. A and B value. What is A value? It won't execute because it's a true, right? It won't execute. 6 and 10. Answer is 6 and 10, guys. Answer 6 and 10. Which option? C, not B. Why B? R operator, right? That is Srikar Jahnavi. Jai Sampriti. Yes, it's a correct. Kirti. Why B answer? You want increment, right? Logical operators, yeah, I told you, right? Logical operators is what? We should follow that rule. What is our rule? The logical operators, I told you, right? These are relation, this one. Yeah, this one. What is this? Logical AND. If the first expression is true, this logical AND. If the first expression is true, it doesn't evaluate second expression. I told you it is true, right? Same. If it is a plus plus a 6, 6 means true. It evaluate, it prints this value. It doesn't evaluate the other values. Clear? Yeah, now this one, 12th one, guys. Tell me the answer for 12th one. Yeah, very good. A right shift one. We are printing a value or not. See this a value you are printing. A value is modifying or not. We are not modifying a value. Answer is what? If it is true or false, a right shift one. What is a right shift one? 2 by 2 power 1. It's a 1. 1 means true. True means a value. A value is 2. Answer is C. How many of you said correct answer, guys? Shruti, correct. Pratyusha, correct. Tejaswini, Kirti, yes. Tejaswini, Kirti, right? Dharani, Suswamika, Sushmita, Sai Sampriti, right? Very good. Chandana, Shrikar. It's wrong, Chandana. Answer is wrong. Shrikar, wrong. Soumyashri, wrong answer, right? Yeah. You understood, right? These are the control statements, guys. Tomorrow onwards, I will start pointers topic. Do you have any doubts today, class? And also try these patterns. If you did not get any pattern, tell me, guys, tomorrow class.